I was in the coffee shop messing around with my MP3s last year. The coffee shop will not be named, but I think we all know which one it is. It's a local coffee shop that I went to because the line for the Wawa was almost out the door for some bizarre reason for coffee because it was a coffee special day. And the weather wasn't cooperating. It wasn't exactly raining like it is now, but it was not cooperating, period. So the line was out the door. So I'm in this coffee shop with my old computer, my old laptop, and I'm messing around with my own MP3s and my radio playlist, my station playlist. With headphones on, of course, because I'm not going to blast out the coffee shop with heavy metal. Or should I at this point? I don't know. It's crossed my mind. But I'm sitting there messing with the MP3s, and some random somebody or other walks up to me and says, "Why is your station called the Bull?" I'm like, it's called the Bull because I just like it and I have a bull sound effect. I like the name the Bull, so I just decided to call it the Bull. It's like the Bull radio station. Why is your station called the Bull? I'm like, what do you have wrong with the Bull? What do you think I should call it? It's a classic rock station. I think it kind of fits. And then this random somebody or other decides to tell me that he must have spotted the fact that I was running old Duke Nukem clips as part of the identifiers. And he's like, "Oh, this is a guy." He's like, "Oh my God. Is your station trying to be hyper masculine?" I'm like, "No, I don't even know what that term means, and I wasn't even trying. I just thought Duke Nukem, some of the things Duke Nukem says would go good with classic rock. Like he's always like he's talking about rocking, and that's one of the ones I have in there is like rocking." And I have "I came here to chew bubble gum and kick ass," or whatever he says. "I came here to kick ass and chew bubble gum, and it looks like I'm all out of gum." That one. I had that one on there. Had a couple of things. And I'm like, and then he goes away and he comes back and he's got a friend with him. I'm like, "Okay, what's this?" And they're both like, "Are you really serious about putting that hyper masculine radio station on the air?" I'm like, "I like classic rock. I like heavy metal." I'm like, "What is hyper masculine?" So I had to go in the coffee shop right there and I had to look up the term hyper masculine right there in the middle of the coffee shop. And I had, cause I want to know what this whole thing was about. Since when I hear a new term I've never heard before, I look it up to try to see if I can learn more about it right then and there, cause that's how I am. So I'm now, instead of working on my MP3s and my sounders and also some text to speech stuff, I'm now looking up terms on the internet because it leads me into these other terms, all these other similar terms. People that search for this search for X. And I'm like, "Whoa, whoa, 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 time out." And I'm just now back to looking up. I'm now just back to looking up free sound effects and getting some of my text to speech stuff worked out at this point. And I'm back to working on the station. So now I don't work on my MP3s in the middle of coffee shops. I was not even on one of the middle tables because I needed to be near an outlet because my computer's old. So yeah, that was my introduction basically to something's up, something's big time up. Yeah, so I'm like, wait a minute. And now look where we are. Oh my God, the bull is hyper-masculine. Classic rock and roll station called the bull is hyper-masculine. And now look where we are. So I was like, screw it. I'm turning it back to the monster. I'm turning my channel back into Metal Steve. So I did. Even got some of the old monster sounders from my old computer. Later.